Please stand. Come on, all of you, stand up. grateful. I've learned a lot about giving, and I'm very fortunate. I come from a very humble background, but with a lot of love. And my mom taught me to give, always, no matter what, no matter how much I have. I'm very grateful that my children are here. They're with me through thick and thin. The committee has been amazing. I have another amazing woman that I need to bring up here, Paula Black. Paula Black has been my friend for 20-something years. They've raised together 8 children and 2 grandchildren that she has. I count them as mine also. Paula is very special. We've been through thick and thin. And Paula actually introduced me to Miracle Babies, even though I did not know Sean or John, by telling you at the meeting she had with the founding members. So she's here tonight. She is our honorary chair tonight. Paula Black. Ms. Paula.
I'm a theatrical producer, and I do not usually take the stage. The work that I do is behind the scenes, whether I'm in Sydney, Australia, New York on the runway, or London's West End. It's usually out of my comfort zone, but because I'm passionate about Miracle Babies, I'd like to speak to each and every one of you in the only way I can from this podium. Thank you, Sean and Marjan, Miriam and Machado, and all of the amazing event committee chairs who put so much love and hard work into this stunning, stunning gala evening we are enjoying tonight. Bravo. I'm humbled. I'm very moved as a past board member of Miracle Babies to be myself tonight's honorary chair of the Moonlight Casablanca Gala. Thank you to everyone in this room tonight, and I'm talking to all of you who chose to honor Miracle Babies by your own presence. You are each appreciated and make the difference in tonight's event. We stand up as supporters of Miracle Babies. Hold on. I told you I'd agree a little bit. And their mission statement, which is to bridge the gap between parents and families who desire the closest of bonds with their premature infant. I know this is a critical time in their lives, and it will be a bonding that will carry them for their lifetime. Simply said, at Miracle Babies, we care about you. Stage, and you will have many roles in your lifetime. I say to each of you now, I believe in the beauty of your dreams. You can do that. And I ask you all, what are the roles you'll play in your life and the lives of others?
Absolutely unbelievable. If you'd like to follow along in your program, you absolutely can, but I promise I will describe them for you.
$8,500, ladies and gentlemen, we've got enough fuel to get you there. Now we need to fuel it to go back. $8,000.
Ladies and gentlemen, up to 38.
I've been told I only have 2 minutes to speak and I can't cry. That's a tough task for me. You guys, there are a lot of physicians in this room, and I tell you, we, all of us who go into medicine, we become doctors, but when we start practicing medicine, we become better human beings. And it's because of our teachers, the mothers, the children, the families, who have taught me so much in the last 13 years of practice. You know, I have to tell you, these are really exciting times for Miracle Babies. When we first started this charity, I was always coached with good intentions. Sean, talk about the sick babies. That's what draws attention to people. That's what people support. But I have to tell you, I have focused over the past 5.5 years on women. And I want to tell you why. When the sperm and egg come together and create these angels that we unconditionally love so much, the structure of that DNA is untouched. But what we're learning now since 2003, since the Human Genome Project completed, is that the function of that DNA can change depending on what genes are expressed. And that depends on environmental influences. So our work of uniting women with their sick newborns to touch that child, to be able to bring breast milk to that child, our work with federally funded community clinics to try to get women who are underprivileged healthier by providing organic produce, educating them on mental and physical well-being, and exercise program. What it's doing is changing the way those genes will be expressed. Not only helping that child as a newborn, but for years to come. Isn't it exciting to know that these 9 months are so crucial? Our women do such an incredible job that they can alter the way our physical health would be, not only just as a newborn, but at the age of 70, 80, 90. My dear guests of honor, I want to thank you for embracing the why as to why you were here. I cried again. I want to thank you for recognizing the role women play in the health of our children. I appreciate you. I just want to thank also, since I only had 2 minutes, and I'm sure I went beyond that, Charo, Miriam, Arjan, Esther, our incredible committee members, our staff at Miracle Babies, our volunteers here tonight. We could not do this without you. Thank you so much.
Habibi.